Yo, peace. This is LaShame the Guard. Briefly, before we get into this video, do me a favor. I got another channel called Smart Money Moves, where I'll give you the tools to make smart money moves. This joint is for beginners on banking, cryptocurrency, stocks, future trading, and more. So, yo, the link will be in description. Subscribe to the channel, Smart Money Moves. And the logo is the Thinking Man, because the Thinking Man gonna win. So tap in and enjoy this video. Peace, y'all. LaShame the Guard. Keep loading the channel. Let's do that right. Little black paddock, something like. But yo, check it. Let's get right into this video. All right. All right, look. As you all know, Big Juk, Yo Gotti's brother, got moked out in Memphis. You feel me? Somebody ran through and sent them up. You feel me? That's a crazy situation. But let's just go back for a minute, right? Because it's alleged that Big Juk put 40 bands on Young Dawg's head, right? Okay. So let's get into that for a minute. It was a few years back, and you all remember Young Dawg came back to Memphis. To, I think, give out turkeys to people and just do his shit, you know what I mean? Because he was the type of person that helped his community, you feel me? From what I'm hearing, because I don't know him personally, right? But from what I'm seeing and hearing. All right, look, it was a sad situation where Young Dawg got sent up, you feel me? And the man was allegedly going to get his mother some cookies or going to get himself some cookies or whatever, right? And a whole bunch of people conspired to backdoor him. You feel me? Which means set him up in other terms. Y'all already know. But the shit is super crazy because it's alleged that they let off 7,500 rounds or whatever, right? That man was probably online getting his little cookies or whatever, and it just popped or whatever, right? But it's alleged he got hit 30-something times. Even if he got hit one time, it moked him, you feel me? And look, pardon me, it's a sad situation to whereas his family was able to witness that. I'm talking about a lot of people love Dawg, you feel me? I fucked with Dawg hard myself because I'm going to get into that later on. But, like, it's a sad situation. The man was laying there. The glass was cracked. I think his arm was laying through the glass of the cookie shop. He all twisted in there. And look, you got to say, for what? Why this occur? For some ego shit? I'm the king of Memphis. You the king of Memphis. Start some argument shit over that. Nigga do a video with your chick in it or whatever. Super crazy. But whatever reason it happened, it just was a sad situation, right? Now, this is what I want to get into. Young Dawg was well-loved, not only in Memphis. Okay, real quickly, let me just touch on this briefly. All right. It's a sad situation because, look, I'm from the hood too, you feel me? And I grew up in some of the toughest hoods in New York, you feel me? But look, I know people get moked out every day, right? And that's the point I want to touch on. Because We as black people, especially in the urban communities, you feel me, dig me? Just hear me out. We as black people, especially in these urban communities, we done got so used to somebody we know getting moked out, a family member getting moked out, a fellow gang member getting moked out, or you don't even know them. Just people in your community getting moked out. But we got so callous with this shit, meaning cold-hearted with it, that we don't really have regards for human life. And that's why a lot of people be getting sent up. You feel me? Like, feel me. If somebody, and y'all get in the comments and y'all tell me about this. If somebody is threatening you and your family or trying to bring you bodily harm, then that's something different. But dudes be getting sent up almost every day. And it don't be a nigga that's bringing them harm. It don't be a dude. It be some, I'm the king of Memphis. You the king of Memphis. I put your girl in a video. I had your girl. Or some talk shit. You feel me? And look, don't get me wrong, from the hood. Like Sun Tzu said, protect your reputation at all costs. So, but it just messed up when it gets like that. You feel me? So like I was saying, and I want to say this one more time. For all of those that are smart, just listen to me. Look, we as blacks, Latinos, or just people living in an urban community, we shouldn't have to be so in acceptance of death of people in our communities, because we act like it ain't nothing when somebody gets sent up, but it really is. And look, we should want more for ourselves and our community. Yeah, let me change it up for a minute. All right, look. Before young Dorf got sent up in a cookie shop or moked out, right? I really didn't know too much about him. And I maybe I heard one or two of his songs. I'm from New York, so I really didn't know about young Dorf. Now, Gotti, I knew about, and I was fucking with Gotti. I won't say crazy hard, but I was fucking with Gotti. I knew he was official. I fucked with him. You feel me? All right. But young Dorf, I ain't know about him until he got sent up in a cookie shop, right? So look, when I start to check Dorf out, I start to listen to some of his songs. I checked out a couple of his videos, and then I checked out like two of his documentary shits or the mini movie shits on him. Yeah, that was a real dude, man. And look, salute and yo, rise and power to young Dorf, man. And look, I really felt that dude. And I ain't know him, but like something within that dude just resonated with me. And look, it resonated on a high level. Look, like Nipsey, his shit resonated with me on a high level, right? And Dorf and Nipsey was kind of similar. But look, Tupac, and I know a lot of y'all might say some crazy shit, but whatever, get in the comments. But look, Tupac, Dorf, Young Dorf, and Nipsey Hussle was three crazy special motherfuckers, you feel me? And like, they all resonated with me. Once I got to know their body of work and I did my due diligence and checked them out, they all resonated with me. Now, Tupac, I've been rocking with him, but Nipsey Hussle and Dorf, I had to get into a little bit. You feel me? But the reason why I said all three of their names together, because I was thinking, like, if I had a chance to just chill with one of them, which one would I chill with? And this ain't no disrespect to Tupac, because I fuck with Tupac hard body. So I don't want y'all to misinterpret me. But Nipsey was a nigga that was... And look, Tupac might have had more money than him, which I think he didn't. He generated more money than both of them together. But Tupac, as far as having millions in his bank account, millions in his pocket, nah, Suge was just going, here, take some money, take some cars, all them shits was in Suge's name, leased to Death Row and shit like that. And everybody know that, right? So that's the point that I'm emphasizing. Tupac was so hard on the black militant shit, and he got into his thug life shit and all that, and he was changing up to Dear Mama and Me Against the World and so many hits he got, right? He was so focused on that shit and getting distracted by a lot of other things. And plus, he was a young brother, 24, 25, you feel me? So he didn't really have time to mature his shit hard. And look, he was still mature. He still was articulate. I'm not taking nothing from him. But as far as being business savvy, he couldn't fuck with Dolph. He couldn't fuck with Nipsey. You see how Nipsey was changing his whole community? Maybe Tupac was going to do that type of shit down the line. But he was leaving the business shit up to, I think he was signed with Interscope, letting them handle shit. And he was letting Death Row handle shit. He was like trusting people and shit like that. Nipsey was on every dollar. Dolph was on every dollar. And look, what I admire about, I excluded Nip, I excluded Tupac. Y'all get in the comments, whatever. But this is just my choice. If I could chill with any one of them, I'm saying, damn, now it's just Nipsey and Dolph left, right? Nipsey was a real dude, like a straight soldier, some hard shit. And he could be smooth at the same time, but he wasn't nothing to play with. Like, the nigga would get busy if he had to. And same shit with Dolph and Pac, you feel me? But Dolph personality, he could laugh and joke and chill. And look, that nigga was so hard on making his people go up. That's why I would have fucked with Dolph, even over Nipsey probably. Now, them two is kind of a toss-up because Nip Hustle was stupid special. But I think I still would have fucked with Dolph because his personality was like kind of in sync with mine as far as his intentions. And then his moves were solid. Look, Dolph said, and I heard him say this himself, if I'm not mistaken. He said, for each one of my kids' birthday, even though they little, 3, 4, each year, he brought them like 2 properties so they could have when they get older. That's some dope shit. And then look, I seen Dolph interacting with his cousin, Keep Glock or whatever. And look, Keep Glock, let me just say this too. When Dolph got sent up, he got moked out in the cookie shop. I was like, damn, I had seen a documentary with him and Keep Glock. Yo, he gave his little cousin a car. He looked out for him and he taught him how to get money. That was the main shit. He taught him how to get money. And look, I'm like, damn, Dolph left. He was building his little empire. He turned down a 20-something million dollar contract. That nigga was about his business, you feel me? And look, I ain't even gonna get into God, he wanted to sign him and then that shit. I'm just talking about Dolph right now. You feel me? So Dolph on his shit, teaching Key Glock how to get money. I think Key Glock came out of a club or somewhere. Nigga had a big stupid, if it wasn't a Rolls Royce or Benz or some shit, he's like, he told Dolph, you got a new car? He's like, nah, that's for you, little cousin. And then they start locking in with the nigga, teaching him to get money. Now, that's the fact that I'm saying, look how it played out. When Dolph got moked out in the cookie shop, I was like, damn, he was building his empire. That nigga was mad small. I'm like, damn, his shit might fall now. Now, he taught them niggas right. Keep Glock holding that shit down. He got fucking pre going up. That shit is going up. Them rappers all say, yo, we can't let Dolph down. We gonna upstep our writing game. The nigga that make the beats, like, nigga, we gotta do this for Dolph. And they did that shit. And not only did they do that, they did all that other shit too. You know what I mean? Like, they ain't gonna just do that to Dolph. And that shit gotta be respected. But at the same time, yo, it's always a tragic situation, like I say, when anybody gets sent up, right? So, it's bad that Big Jook got sent up, you know what I mean? But, I don't know, man, like, karma's a universal principle of cause and effect. If you had anything to do with Dolph getting sent up, and you allegedly you gave niggas $40,000, what you give out to the universe, that shit'll give back to you eventually, because karma is the universal principle of cause and effect. So that means for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. Yo, y'all get in the comments, and yo, make sure you subscribe. If you're not subscribed, the channel is Keep Low, and I'm Lost Shane the God. But let's continue. So check it on right now, I'm bringing the shit up to speed, right? Okay, we all know that Big Jook got robbed, and he was coming from his uncle or his cousin, whoever's funeral, right? So he came out of that, and then he went to the repass. And people just caught him outside the repass and just sent him up. You feel me? But look, his mom's was allegedly in the truck or near him or some shit like that. She was riding with him. And it's alleged that this lady had to jump out the car and run for her life and watch her son get toasted up. You feel me? And that's her baby. You feel me? That's any mother. So condolences to their family on that note. But like everybody say, look, Gotti just did a show. I just seen this shit on all these platforms, right? He had on all white. He came out in Detroit, mad people, and he like, yo, we keep it solid, which I expected of him. I didn't expect him to say that shit, but I expected him to definitely, you know what I mean? So I'm like, I know Gotti serious, and that shit ain't gonna go like that. That's his physical brother. So that's just 2 and 2 make 4. That's common sense. Any street nigga know that. But look, how the F can I tell somebody, yo, son, you be easy, and your brother just got sent up. You feel me? Cause I know he see red. You feel me? So, certain shit you just let be. You feel me? And it's just a tragic situation because motherfuckers is dropping on both sides. And it's super crazy. But look, I seen black youngster doing what he do. And you know, everybody's locked in and they going to stay solid. But touching on that situation, Gotti's a grown man. He could do whatever he do. So he did what he did when he said that shit to the crowd, that we street niggas, we don't tell nobody, we gonna keep it solid. So he told you. You know what I mean? So I guess y'all better believe him. But what I'm saying is, he said he gonna have his brother's funeral in Memphis. And it's gonna be a public funeral. I think that's that. I don't know, man. I think you got guap. I would have just flew my family and close immediate friends out to a public memorial for my brother. Took care of that shit. Them Alphabet dudes is looking. Memphis PD. They couldn't really handle the situation. So the feds came in and they was like, let us handle this shit. Because this shit looking bad worldwide. You feel me? So the feds got involved now. Some Alphabet dudes is waiting to take millions and take a company from a black nigga. You feel me? And then there's people who's waiting for all of y'all to kill one another. Your lives don't mean nothing to these rich people that's into that shit like that. Y'all don't mean nothing to them. You just another nigga on some real shit. And yo, I don't want to get my channel flagged, but you just another. That's all it is, man. Your life ain't worth nothing to these people. So the people who sitting back manipulating the situation, they watching y'all bang each other out. But now let's look at it from another perspective. Dolph was giving mad people jobs back to his community, donating shit to his community. He said, I heard him say with his own mouth that when people couldn't pay their mortgage and shit they was behind, he was paying the whole shit. Paying the whole shit off. They was asking him for one payment. That nigga was coming through. Miss Brown, I knew you for a long time, and just smashing him out. And he was doing crazy shit like that because he was getting to the guap. And look, don't get me wrong, Gotti got a whole payroll of motherfuckers, and I'm pretty sure he providing for his family and loved ones too. But look, y'all was both building Memphis up together, and now look, y'all at war, and two empires getting ready to fall if y'all don't make the proper moves. So that goes out to Key Glock, that's holding down Pre, and that go out to Gotti, that's holding down his shit. And y'all gotta make smart moves. But yo, don't listen to me. You could take my advice or throw it away. But to the rest of y'all, y'all get in the comments and y'all tell me what y'all think. You feel me? And if you don't know me, my name is Lashane the Guard. I have a channel called Keep Low on YouTube where I do videos on street legends. I mean, the best of them. And I give you real spit. And I also drop knowledge that'll help you elevate your life. And I also drop knowledge for the guard, the earth, and the babies. So tap into the channel Keep Low. Never tell, they'll never know. You dig? Drop your comments in the comment section. Yo, if you enjoyed this video, give this video a thumbs up. Hit the notification bell so you'll be notified when I drop more fire content. And yo, just tap in with the channel. Subscribe. You already know. Once again, we in your area. And if you don't know, it's keep low. Never tell, they never gonna know. Lashing the God, yo. We out. Peace, y'all.